Hi everyone, welcome to YouTube Video World. This is Varun Ganga. Guys, in the last session we have seen an example in which Vartha Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram is used to find the square of a given recurring number. With respect to the same shortcut, in this session we are going to have one more example, and the example that I am going to take in this session is 9 nines whole square. So guys, to find the square of a given recurring number, at first we have to find three important key terms. And the first key term that we are going to find here is Cn. Cn is nothing but a compounding number, and it is found out by picking up one of the digits of the given recurring number and squaring it and again adding the products. So here I am just picking one of the 9 and I am squaring it, I will get 81 as the product. Now 81, I am adding the 8 and 1, I will get 9. So therefore the compounding number here I have got is 9. Moving further, the next key term that I am going to find here is Dn. Dn is a diminishing number, and it is found out by multiplying the Cn and the number of digits. So here I have got Cn as 9, and the number of digits that are in the recurring number are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So 9 into 9, I will get 81 as the product. Again 8 plus 1, I will get 9 as the Dn. So here in this case I have got Cn as 9 and Dn as 9. Now the last key term that I am going to find here is the number of digits that are going to be have in the answer. And in the previous sessions I have already told you that the number of digits that are going to be in the answer will be always twice the number of digits that are in the question. So here in the question I am having 9 digits, so therefore in the answer I will be having twice the number of digits that are in the question, and therefore 9 into 2 I will get 18. And I can say that there will be 18 digits in the answer after squaring the given recurring number. Now let us see how we are going to use this Vartha Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram in finding the square of the given recurring number. And the process goes like this. The first thing that I am going to do here is, I am going to pick up the unit digit of the given recurring number and I am going to square it. So 9, after squaring this 9, I will get 81 as the product. Since 81 it is a 2 digit number, so we have to ignore the digit that is in tens place. So I am ignoring here 8, and I am going to take the digit that is in ones place, and therefore I am taking 1 here, and I am going to write this 1 in the result like this. Now moving further, now what I am going to do here is, I am going to take the Cn and I am going to add this Cn to the first digit that I have got in the answer, that is to the 1. So 9 plus 1, I will get 10. 10, it is a 2 digit number, so we have to take the digit that is in 1's place, that is 0, and we have to write it in the result. And the digit that is in 10's place, that is 1, should be taken as carry on. So in the answer we will be having 0 and 1. Moving further, we have to take Cn and we have to add to it to the second digit what we have got in the answer, that is to 0. So 9 plus 0, we will get 9 again, but there is 1 carry on, we have to add to it, we will get 10 as the sum. 10, it is a 2 digit number, so we have to take 0 and we have to write it in the answer, and 1 should be taken as carry on. Now in the answer we will be having 001. Moving further, we have to continue the process until we get 9 digits of the answer. You know, I have said only 9 digits, why? Because we will be having 18 digits in the answer. If we get 9 digits of the answer, and the remaining 9 digits can be obtained by subtracting each of the 9 digits from that many Dn's, that is 9 nines. So here, now I am going to stop the process after getting the 9 digits of the answer. And therefore in the compounding section, I will be having 8 zeros with 1 9 as the 9 digits of the answer. Now, what I am going to do here is, I am going to subtract all these 9 digits from that many Dn's, that is 9 nines. And the process will be going like this. I am going to write the 9 Dn's like this, and below it the digits that have got in the compounding section, that is 0000001 below it. Now by subtracting 9 minus 1 I will get 8, and 9 minus 0 you will get 9, so you will be getting 99999. So by clubbing both these two answers, that is 9999999998 and 00000001, I will get the final answer. And therefore we can say that the square of 9 nines is equals to 9999999H00000001. So guys, this is the way how you can find the square of a given recurring number by using Bharata Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram. So guys, I hope that you have got understood how to use this Bharata Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram in finding the square of a given recurring number. I hope that you have understood pretty well, and I do hope that you do use this same shortcut whenever it is necessary. So guys, this is the last example of this session regarding to the square of a given recurring number by using Bharata Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram. And in the next session, we are going to learn how to use this same Bharata Siddhantam Chudamani Sutram in finding the product of a given recurring numbers of different digits. So guys, for watching this video, thank you. Have a nice day.